Now, armed with these rules, we can now finally derive the supply curve. Remember, we derived the demand curve last time, a number of lectures ago, by just showing by getting the tangency at different price ratios with the difference curves. We'll derive the firm supply function. What we now need to do is say, okay, at different prices, how much will the firm produce? Well, we can now get that if we go to figure 11.1. We can now see the supply curve for this firm. What we see is at a price of 3, it will produce 3 units. At a price of 4, it will produce 4 units, etc. The supply curve is the marginal cost curve. Dun, dun, dun. So now we know where supply curves come from. Supply curves are marginal cost curves above the point where price equals average variable cost. So the definition of a firm supply curve is the marginal cost curve above P greater than or equal to average variable cost. That is the firm short-run supply curve. Now, in our case, P is always greater than the average variable cost. The second condition is irrelevant. It's just so the firm supply curve is just literally that marginal cost curve. With different functions, which you may at some day see in a problem set or an exam, that won't be true. Okay? So in that case, you need to check that profit, that shutdown condition. This is the firm's supply curve. Now, of course, what we talked about in the first lecture was not firm supply curve, but market supply curves. So now let's take the next step and say, well, where do market supply curves come from? We now know where firm supply curves come from. Okay, the marginal cost stork brings them. Okay, now where do market supply curves come from? The first step of short run is you're going to enter this market. And to enter this market, you're going to have an amount of capital you're going to pick. Okay, so each firm is going to have some cost function, which involves picking some amount of capital or fixed costs. Okay, it's going to say, I want to build a building this big. Okay, having built that building, we're going to get the firm supply curve, which is P equals MC. Okay? That's step one. That's the step we've derived. Okay. The second step is we're going to add up the firm supply curves to get a market supply curve. We're going to add up the firm supply curve to get a market supply curve. So for example, suppose that there's 5 firms in the market. Okay? So this is the second step, is how we get to that short-run market supply curve. Okay? Each firm has a marginal cost curve. Okay? And here we're using our same cost function we've used. That same cost function up there where price equals marginal cost, where P equals Q is the supply curve. So each firm has that supply curve you see in the first panel. Then what you see is as you add more firms, the second panel gives you the market supply curve. So if there's only one firm in the market, the market supply curve would be S1. Now, if there were 2 firms in the market, the market supply curve is S2. That is, at a price of 2, you're now producing 4 units in the market. If there's 3 firms, the curve is S3, 4 firms S4, and so on. As you add more firms, that market supply curve shifts out and becomes flatter. Okay? Remember, firms are identical here. We're adding identical firms. That was an assumption of perfect competition. We're adding more and more identical firms producing the same good. And you see that market supply curve is shifting out and becoming flatter. Okay? That is, the supply of goods is becoming more elastic as there are more firms. The third step is we intersect market supply with market demand to get the equilibrium price. So in other words, we say, look, there's some market supply, which we've derived. Now let's imagine some market demand, and that'll give us the equilibrium price. So for example, in our case, market supply is what? Market supply is we have, let's say, for example, there's five firms in the market, just to make an example. Let's say five firms have entered. There's five firms in the market. Well, the total market supply Q is five of the little Qs, because there's five identical firms in the market. Okay? Five identical firms are in the market. Well, we know from the marginal cost condition that's the same as saying Q equals 5 times P. So our market supply curve, which is actually S5 on figure 11.2, is Q equals 5P. You could see that, because when the price is 2, Q equals 10. When the price is 5, Q equals 25. Okay? So you could see that S super 5 is the market supply curve. Big Q equals 5P. Okay? Now let's say the market demand. Let's just make this up. So this is the quantity supply. Let's say the demand function is that the quantity demanded, okay, is 30 minus P. That is, we have a downward sloping. I just made this up. We have a downward sloping. Well, I'm making all this up, but just an example demand curve, okay? We have a downward sloping demand curve with a slope of negative 1, okay? The quantity demanded is 30 minus P. So to get equilibrium, we set these equal, and we get that 30 minus P equals 5P, or P equals 5. Okay? 30 minus P equals 5P, or P equals 5. That's the equilibrium price. Given the market supply curve, given the demand curve, I've derived the equilibrium price of 5. Okay? Now, at a price of 5, what's the quantity demanded? At a price of 5, quantity demanded equals 25. So at a price of 5, the market wants 25 of these things, whatever the heck it's producing. Okay, at a price of 5, the market wants 25 of them. Okay, that's the quantity demanded. Then the final step in solving for equilibrium is that each firm then decides how much to produce. Each firm decides how much to produce. Okay? Well, what is each firm going to decide to produce? How much is each firm going to decide to produce? Somebody raise their hand and tell me. Yeah? P, which is?
5.
So each firm is going to produce 5. How many firms are there?
5.
How much gets produced?
25.
Which is exactly what people want. We're done. That's the magic of the market. Okay? Through these four steps, we've got an equilibrium, which is defined as the quantity supplied equals the quantity demanded. So basically, what do you need to find equilibrium? What do you need to find the short-run equilibrium? To find the short-run equilibrium, you need a demand function, a cost function, and a number of firms. You have to be given a number of firms because there's no entry and exit in the short run, remember.